Alright, so now we're talking bringing in new generation, another generation, and with each generation, well, we can almost take ourselves back into the past and go, wait a minute, even Victorian era, they had etiquette lessons and all kinds of things, you know. Protocols and etiquettes. So how is that, how are we going to take those, yes, stiff and tight, all of that, how are we going to take that into the future, you know? So I'm wielding my mind around and going, well, maybe, you know, it's not really the etiquette and the protocol with other people so much. It actually has to do with the human themselves on their relationship with the planet. That's the etiquette and protocol that we have to start flourishing. And when I say etiquette and protocol, I mean, well, okay, let's say you are about to go and see somebody and their dog and say hello to that dog. Alright, let's say you take that dog and you go and you shake it really hard like that, you know, and even the owner is like, what did he do to my dog, you know, why did he do that, you know, what right did you have to do that to my dog, you know, so there is shaking this man's dog, and the dog even is in shock, okay. So in those moments, that is a person that is expelling bad etiquette, bad protocol. So when we are looking at ways to amend ourselves as a human race, we have to have etiquette in those situations. You know, when you go up to a dog, are you even supposed to, you know, pet it heartily? You know? Depends on the animal, you know. Or you know, the more heartily you pet it, then you end up with pit bulls. In a wrestle fight. Why is that something to attain or wanna be like? Wouldn't you want your pit bull to be just like a little pansy and go, oh my gosh, no, don't touch me that way, you know, no. Wouldn't you prefer your pit bull to be that way? Why the aggression with touch, I'll say, straight away. We have these fingers, you know, and so do, you know, the monkeys, all of the monkeys have fingers. Very adept. We are very adept at using them. However, we mistreat them. We grab things really mean, and then we wonder why we get arthritis. Treat everything lightly. You know, this pen, the anything. You know, you touch a plant. You know, don't grab at the leaves and shake it. Don't ever do that. I mean, a plant has an aura, has its space, you know. Maybe when you're gonna pick it, finally, you know, show some respects at that moment and go to take the plant out of the earth. Maybe then. But even that, you have to be gentle. Have to be gentle, and I'm like, well, how can we get people to love animals more, be more compassionate human beings? And I'm like, well, you could look at ballet. You know, there we are all those years as ballet dancers, ballerinas, holding on to the bar very lightly. We're not allowed to touch it really heavy. We're not allowed to grab at the bar. It has to be very light. And even if you later on in your years you have a partner, a dance partner, it's very light. You're not allowed to grab hold of them, even though you might have to sometimes, but you're not really allowed to. So all of those are lessons for ballet people, you know. But not everybody takes ballet. Not everybody takes ballet. So if you have like little kids and they're just aggressive with their items, you know, maybe these things that have to be taught at parent level, they have to be taught in a school level. Maybe we just have to start teaching, be gentle. Be gentle with everything. Be gentle with items, products. Be gentle with plants. Be gentle with animals. Be gentle. And I mean it. And because that, in essence, it just takes us like, well, approachability. You know, if I'm going to approach something, I'm going to approach something that's beautiful and I really, really like, it doesn't mean I can go take it and grab at it, you know, like I'm the last shopper on earth, you know. No. What does that solve? You know? And especially if it's a nature item. Oh my gosh, do you see that rock on the ground? I just have to have it. You know what I mean? Do you run over and just grab that rock up and then just say, that's my rock? Or do your eyes warm to the rock first as you select it, and then you gently pick it up so you don't pull a muscle in your back? I mean, all of these things are lessons on how to treat ourselves and how to treat our bodies. And don't they make for better human beings if we are more gentle? I mean, I purposely do not touch my plants at all, not at all, until I finally decide to select a leaf or something. I do not touch them. It's their life. It's their journey. I have to respect their aura and give them the biggest aura possible of allow, you know. And we know all of this about healing and touch. You know, you touch a human being. You go into the healing space because the aura has a healing space. You if you touch them too hard, it takes many, many hours and days sometimes to rebuild that area in your aura to its full capacity. So we already know all of this. Science has figured that out. So we have to be gentle. We have to be gentle human beings. And maybe that in itself, you know, if we can teach that to the young, to be gentle, maybe they will in turn take the world in gentle hands also, and not be such killants, not be such disposables of this and disposables of that, and in life included. So let's think about that. Well, it is a grown-up, isn't it? It's a grown-up skill. It's a grown-up ability, but I know little children who are very respectful of things also. Now, they can be respectful of things if they've been intimidated, you know, but that's not the way to go. You're not supposed to intimidate the child, you know, don't touch. You know, the items in that store are, you know, you're going to not have anything good in your lunch for a week. You know, that's not the way to go. You know, it really is supposed to be the child's natural learned self to not be aggressive. Not be aggressive. And what will that be for us as a society in the future? Oh my God, how great. How absolutely great. Anyway, so let's think about that. Gentle. We need gentle classes. You know that, you know, in a way, you think about the arts. They used to have a lot of arts in the schools. You know, they had the violin. You could go take violin. Or I played the French horn, of all things. But yeah, all of those items, you know, you can take the arts. You can take a dance. You can take theater in school. Those types of things, you know, they have tried to take away a lot. But those are gentle. Those are gentle gives, aren't they? They're gentle gives. learns to the person, you know, gentle to themselves, gentle to others. I mean, we know there are situations, but my gosh. And worse is, you know, the older you get, it's just like, you know, oh my gosh, I can grab the cup and then hopefully I don't drop it, you know, that type of thing going on. So we start to lose our gentle. So if we can just maybe attune our gentle selves throughout our lives as much as possible, maybe it'll makes for a much better older age. Oy, oy, oy. Anyway, so that's it. And that's no more touching of the plants. I'm gonna make a rule.